What's going on, everyone? We're going to be talking about what is Web3 and how is it different from Web1 or Web2, and what exactly is Web 3.0. So let's get into it. Image demonstrates that the best Web 1.0 is very aesthetic web-only web pages, like your MSN, your AOL, Explorer, that sort of thing. Web 2.0 is more of the Facebooks, the social media, where you can read and write on the actual website, so information-centric and interactive. So you're able to really engage with the website versus just kind of read it and be it static. And that's kind of your Facebook, your Meta, your Netflix, Google Drive, Twitter, Amazon Web Services. And so Web 3.0 is more of a decentralized, where it's not controlled by any entity, but it's controlled by the masses. And so that can be decentralized, it could be private, but it is where you own your own assets, essentially. It's a very transparent record-keeping system, and it's a very good way to monitor who sees your data and who doesn't. So Web 3.0 is a more of a privacy concern to the end user. And so Web 2.0 would be like a Chase or a Citibank or a Bank of America holding your digital money, while MetaMask, you're holding your own through a wallet of sorts. And you are actually holding the assets and you're in control of those assets. Another example would be a tokenizing of real-world assets. So people who would take, say, for instance, a part of a business and put it up for sale on the blockchain instead of, say, stocks. Or they would, say, sell a portion of the real estate instead of a REIT. So all these different ways to the different differentiate between Web 2 and Web 3. Another sector that this is going to be major in Web 3.0 is definitely the play to earn or gaming space. We can look at games just like World of Warcraft, that it's a 2.0 game, but there are people that want to sell in-world game items for real life money. And that is exactly what Web 3.0 is essentially owning our own assets. This is kind of the same thing in a sense, but in a different light. And so you can literally buy any character, any kind of game, any kind of currency for these types of games. Counter-Strike, old school Counter-Strike, has a similar marketplace for CSGO, for skins and items. Every single game has a marketplace where you can buy. If you can trade it, you can essentially buy it for real life money. I think that's really, I've been doing this for forever in the Web 2 space. And now in the Web3 space, you are essentially owning your own asset. The biggest difference being using code to do all the transactions, to do all the trust that the money is going to be where it says it is, and you're able to take that money back, versus trustless, which is using a smart contract or code. So Web2 would be humans, people manually doing things, and Web 3.0 would be more of the code and trusting that the code is actually doing what it says it does. Personally, I think that this is more Web 2.5. I don't think Web 3.0 is really owning assets on the blockchain. I think that's a kind of a mix between Web 2.0 and what they call 3.0. I think the next stage is going to be AR, VR, AI. That's definitely going to be Web 3.0. There has to be a vast difference, I think, between 2 and 3. And so I don't think having, owning digital assets, which really doesn't solve anything because it's really the same thing as owning, when was like the same digits as a card on your bank account as it is on a wallet. I think that the next phase is definitely going to be AR, VR, where we're wearing glasses to see a web on top of the world. I think that is going to be Web 3.0, and that's going to be the major difference. And when you start incorporating digital currencies and AI, I think that's going to be the major changes we'll see for Web 3.0. So that's my predictions. Let me know what you guys think down below. Do you feel that the blockchain is 3.0? Or is it more of 2.5, kind of getting to that 3.0 status? Or do you actually think 3.0 is here? Let me know in the comments down below. I'll see you guys on the next one.